Manuel, this is a quick synopsis of the main thing that we did in class today. So we started working on the first part of our summative for the next 2 weeks, which is our personal food reflection / manifesto. You're going to be using this linked article, Feeding 9 Billion People, to discuss some of the values and opinions that you have about food and the future of food, as well as connecting it to other crises and problems that we've discussed this year. Your async days should be working on the grocery store visit, which is in your work calendar, as well as on Schoology. And then next week, we'll be working on analyzing a recipe for our first annual Stowe Environmental Science Cookbook. So you can get to the article here. And you're going to be reading, you scroll down, a 5-step plan to feed the world, up until step 2, grow more on the farms that we've got. Now, for each section, step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I've written a question for you to respond to based on what the article talks about, and also connections and ideas that you have from other projects, activities, or things that we've talked about throughout the year. These are opinions. I'm looking for you to use clear, detailed, and data-driven answers. But also know that there's no right or wrong answer. I'm really trying to see what you value by writing as much as necessary to convey a really articulate point. But again, as little as possible. Don't write me pages and pages of information. The goal of this article or this document is for you to think about in the year 2050 as you are a professional, accomplished adult. And the world is 9 billion people. What you want the food system to look like in terms of you buying food, how it's made, its environmental impact, and how sustainable it is. So the first step is going to be talking about freezing agriculture's footprint, and I want you to really think about whether or not we should have restrictions or labels or advertisements about food that uses too much land or too many resources, really thinking about specific policies or specific foods that you would like to see in those categories in terms of labeling, advertising. I've given you lots of activities for you to think about in terms of how and why we might want to consider those types of answers. And then the second step, which is growing more food on the farms that we've got, it's going to be asking you to think about whether or not we should value food more based on its humanistic aspects, like locally grown, grown without pesticides, organic, GMO-free, or whether we should focus on buying food based on the environmental aspects in terms of nutrient use, land use, water use, pollution. Should we be buying food just because it's local, or should we be buying food where it's the most efficient and uses the least amount of nutrients to create? So that's really asking you, do you purchase food based on cultural and economic values or environmental importances of trying to reduce your environmental impact? I will see you guys tomorrow in office hours. I'd like you to try and respond to both of these questions using this article and any other things that you need to use. And I hope this helps.